This area is the E&E, electronics equipment. It's located under the floor of the cabin where the passengers are. This is in the forward end near the flight deck or the cockpit. What I'm looking around now is, see, those are the floor beams for the cabin. They're graphite fiber composites. Looking forward up the side of the forward wheel well where the nose gear goes. And so that's the box. This is the computer that one of the computers that I use to troubleshoot the airplane. It's connected to the data bus, which talks to all the systems. These are electronic racks. They're separated electronically as well as physically, so there'll be some on the right and then another system that does the same thing on the left, so that if one side gets damaged, the other side will still be functioning. And they each have their own, like I said, electrical system as well as physical separation, so an accident or a fire most probably won't take out everything all at once. And usually we have a left, right, and center system that does the same thing. So we have backup, and then the third backup. And there we have forward of the little walkway that I'm standing on. We have more electronics physically separated from those on the backside. This is the main battery for the airplane. We've got two of those batteries, one for the APU and one for the main flight deck systems. $45,000 for one of those batteries. Just ordered one. APU battery failed its cap check, which is a capacity check. It is measured by discharge over time. This is the toilet line for the vacuum waste system. All of the joints have this waterproof seal around it. You don't want sewage and water leaking into your electronics, obviously. Those are the heavy power feeder cables. These are the main power feeder cables that come from the engines and the APU. Those are run in a single run from the APU or from the engine generator all the way into this area in one single piece. You don't splice those like you can. And there's no connections or break, what do you call those? Terminal blocks or anything like that. It's all one solid wire from the generator to the distribution panel. This is an anti-static wristband. When I'm working on anything down here, electronics, going to be removing a component, like one of these boxes. If I were to take out one of the boxes, I would pull the circuit breaker to take the power off of that box, plug in this wristband, and then put it on. It has a metal disc on there that discharges electricity or static electricity from my body into that point, so that I don't accidentally discharge static electricity into the component and fry something that's sensitive in there, like a little chip or something that can't take a static shock. These are different wire runs. Some of them are electrical distribution for actually electricals. Others are data for data. There's some fiber optic ones in there. They're separated depending on what they do, because some of them, like the heavy power cables you see, those are separated by themselves. You can't run those with communications cables because the electromagnetic field that emanates around those is so powerful that it would disrupt the communications. Here's the data bus panel where we have the data bus communication for valve positions, system positions, feedback. These are data bus sensor switches. Just tells you if current is on the lines. It's a printed circuit board file. All of those switches will turn off these different circuit cards. Here's a table of contents of what's in the file. each of the cards and what they do, so they have their position and their system that they service. This is some creeping forward into the along the wheel well, getting under the cockpit. These are some of the control mechanisms and rigging that come down from the cockpit controls for flying the airplane. We have the 777 is a fly-by-wire. These are the autopilot servos that move the controls when the autopilot is engaged. There's a spring you can know for the pilot. He can override the autopilot. It takes a lot of force, but not impossible for him to do. If he needs to, the autopilot won't disengage. This is all the way in the forward nose section. Got some guy in there doing some work. We're having quite a bit of work done. A lot of inspections done, so we got people stuffed everywhere in the airplane right now. More control systems. Anyway, what I was saying is that it's fly-by-wire, so the computer, the pilot's input there into the controls, what they want it to do, and the computer sends a signal to a hydraulic servo, but if that system fails, then we have those little backup cables so that the airplane can still be flown manually. Here we are back to the main battery. There's the nose gear steering cables. Got an outlet, ground communications, plugins where I can plug in and talk to people in the cockpit if I need to. This is another electronics panel away from the E&E area. This is about 20 feet behind it in the cargo along the sidewall. So we have physical separation again of another system. This is the right system for some of these components. That way, if the E&E has a fire in it, we still have control here. If we lose all of our electronic systems, we still have backup cable control.